Hello, welcome to my channel Surabhi. I'll be doing the tarot card reading for Scorpios for the month of March. I'm using three tarot decks, the routine red or white tarot deck, the illuminated tarot cards and the guardian angel tarot cards. I'll be using the illuminated tarot only for the clarifiers if I need them. I'll be starting the reading with the red or white tarot deck and then I'll take the help of the guardian angels. I'll be pulling out three cards of your energy, three art cards for the person you're thinking of, and please feel free to swap the energies because they may be vice versa. And if this does not resonate with you, then please check your moon sign and the Venus rising, and obviously it will not resonate with everyone. So these are the energies of the person you've been thinking of, Scorpios. These are your energies and this is your outcome. Wow, at the base, at the bottom of the deck is the King of Cups. So the King of Cups is, it's a positive card, a very emotional person trying to perhaps hold on to his feelings perhaps. And yes, thinking of offering you love. But yes, controlled emotions, authoritative person. Okay, let me see into this. Four of Pentacles, Three of Cups, and the Hermit. Okay, so there has been, you see, the Three of Cups is a very, very bright card. There is a happiness. There is celebration, there is abundance in everything. The Four of Pentacles is the person, he's a person who is completely satisfied. There is no tension with him. There is no, they have everything under his, these materialistic possessions, emotional potentials, possessions, everything is, but just trying to hold to everything. He's not trying to show the feelings. And the Hermit is, maybe this is the divine light. He's just waiting for this person. He's waiting for a divine light, guidance. Standing here in isolation with the lamp, thinking and pondering as to what decision should be made. But what thing is that there is light, which indicates positivity to me. And I think this person is a serious type of a person, contemplating on the various aspects, does not want to do anything in haste. Perhaps let us see your cards. Wheel of Fortune, the Three of Pentacles, and the Eight of Wands. Now, to me it seems that Three of Pentacles is this person is standing on a pedestal, or is top of a decision maker, and both of these ladies are standing there, these people are standing there with some documents or something in their hand. I mean, as if trying to say that just look up to this, and trying to tell some problem or something to this person, and he will give some decision perhaps. There's a Wheel of Fortune. There is something which is happening, which needs a decision, which will be seeking help from others, perhaps. Seeking help from others, and then something is going to happen which will turn the Wheel of Fortune in your favor, because it is a very positive card and there is a lot of communication. Eight of Wands, a lot of communication and love is involved finally. So maybe there is some time which is needed to contemplate, or some decision is yet to be made. That is what I feel. Though everything is fine, there is no problem as such, no major problem as such, but yes, some decision is being awaited, I think, and they are contemplating on it themselves as well as taking help of others, one or the other, and things will be resolved because there is a lot of communication. the outcome. Okay, very good. The outcome again is the Chariot. So again, it is a major arcana, a very positive card. Things will move forward. See the Wheel of Fortune and the Chariot. Both of them, they just denote that the situation is going to move forward. It is going to move forward. There is no doubt about it. There is a lot of communication over here. The Wheel of Fortune, the Chariot, contemplation. So the whatever decision will be made will be right. You are seeking, if you want, you are contemplating yourself also. Both of you contemplating yourself, maybe discussing with each other or with your friends or relatives, and then communication is there with each other or whatever it is, and then things will obviously move forward. Let me see what the guardian angels have to say. Okay, just see. So right, the Two of Thought and fair decisions. The Two of Thought says your angels have noticed that you are not moving forward. You have multiple options that you are reviewing and you seem to be unable to choose. Ask your angels for the signs as to what direction to take, or just listen to your inner voice. Deep down, you know what to do. So this is exactly resonating. The situation is not moving forward. This person is holding the feelings. You are also discussing, though things were in your favor, but still you are thinking, prolonging the thing. And what they are trying to say is the angels say that the things are not moving forward. Maybe you have multiple options, or you are in doubt. You're reviewing the situation and you're not able to come to a decision. And your angels, either you ask your angels, that means either you meditate or you discuss with your friends, listen to your inner voice, whatever it is, and you will come to a conclusion as to what you should do. Fair decisions. Your angels are aware that you have concerns, but be assured that there is nothing to worry about. Stand on your ground and know that heaven is shining its divine light upon the situation. All is being healed. Take time to review all the details thoroughly. Forgiveness will bring peace to everyone involved. So here again, both the cards are suggesting the same thing, that everything, the outcome is fruitful. Everything will move in a forward direction. Contemplate, discuss, take correct decisions, review things, but not so much that you are stuck to the point that you are not able to move forward. Take a right decision and move forward. Don't keep on thinking and coming back. And the number 8 is there, which says that whatever the decision, it will be the right decision. The number 8 is the number of karma. So I guess there is nothing to worry about. You just have to be peaceful, but you don't have to be stagnant. Meditate, pray, discuss, be balanced, and take the right decision. That's all for the Scorpios which I have for the month of March. And thank you. If you like my readings, if they resonate with you, please click the like and the subscribe button. Thank you.